Hey guys, it's me, it's JC, and guess what? It has now been officially 4 years since I have started YouTube. Can you believe it? It's been 4 years already. I can't believe it. It's ridiculous to even fathom that, mainly because when I first started, I never thought I would even be doing it this long. But I quickly found out just how fun it actually ended up being once I got over a lot of the things that I was able to overcome, and it was the reason why I started YouTube. And I've said this many times before, I am not shy about talking about why I started YouTube. I'll say it again for people who do not know this. I started YouTube because I had a lot of problems growing up, from speech problems, being shy, fairly quiet, to just everything that you kind of put together. It was like the opposite of what you would kind of see people on YouTube do. So I thought to myself, if I can do this, it'll help me overcome just everything that I've had in my life. And the biggest thing is that it really gave me a lot more confidence, and it took me a long time. I said in the previous vlog that I did that I feel that now, after all these years later, I'm as confident as I've ever been. And I hope it can show in some of the videos and the work that I do. But it's just so crazy that 4 years later, I'm still doing this. And, you know, am I still having fun? Like, yes, the most fun I've ever had doing anything in my life. And I can't imagine even slowing down whatsoever, because I push myself too hard. And that's the biggest thing, I think, for me personally, that I really don't like that I'm doing. I don't sleep much, so I do a lot of YouTube stuff. And it's good and bad, but it's a lot of bad because it's not healthy, you know what I mean? But I love doing this so much, and there's so much I really want to do. Like, I have a huge list of things I want to do, and it's trying to get it off the ground to actually do it. But we're going to save all that, because that was actually for a New Year's video that I ended up doing. I'll probably leave a link somewhere, an annotation or something, just so you guys can kind of see what I was kind of talking about, I guess would be the way of saying it. But I thought we could have some fun in this video. We're going to answer some questions. I have not done a Q&A in a very, very long time. And I asked people on Twitter, hashtag AskCaseyLovesGaming, just questions in general. And sadly, not many people actually answered questions. For the people who did, that's awesome, because I'm actually going to answer those questions first. I've got it on the side here. But the other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go way back. I'm going to dial back to my last Q&A video, which was like 2015. So I'll take a lot of questions from that and answer those as well. So the first question is from Chris J. Williams, or Kiptup, on Twitter, and they say, what do Canadians think a typical English person is like, and can you do an impression? I don't think impressions are my strong suit, and I think if I tried to do it, I would horribly offend you and every single, you know, English person out there. But what do I think of an English person is like? Well, I think a lot of people around the world think of the whole stereotypical sort of thing, like tea and crumpets, and they dress all nice, and like pip pip cheerio and boulder dashed. I don't know if they say that, but it sounds like something an English person would say. And I think it's the same thing applies to, like, when people think of a Canadian, they probably think of them as it being, like, you know, super handsome and super amazing, and oh no, that's not it, I'm sorry. They probably think of them as being, like, plaid and ice hockey and, you know, lumberjack, this is my lumberjack move, and other stuff. This is going to be a two-part question, as Chrissy was kind enough to leave two questions, and why exclude one of the questions? Why not include both of them? So the first one says, when you're feeling down, what or who keeps you motivated to keep making amazing YouTube videos? Well, thank you, I'm glad you think they're amazing videos, but when I'm feeling down, like everybody, you get those times in your lives where you feel really down in the dumps, I guess would be a way of saying it. And, you know, there's always something you have to do to focus on and kind of take your mind off things, and that's generally another thing that people will say to you, but it is absolutely true. And for me personally, I will usually play video games or something to take my mind off things. Like, I've always enjoyed puzzle games growing up, and I always thought that was a good way of just taking your mind off things, because it forced you to have to focus your, like, brain power on solving things, so that would, like, steer me away from whatever was keeping me down. But sometimes that's not enough, you know, sometimes you need a lift me up as well. And I've found that since I've started doing YouTube, that just the interaction with you guys has really helped me as well, especially with my confidence, because it allows me to just talk to you guys. And when you do YouTube videos, you're by yourself, like, a lot. And by getting a chance to interact with you guys, it just really just takes that away, that whole barrier. And it kind of allows me to, like, let my guard down a little bit and be more myself in that regard. So ever since I started live streaming, it has been easily the best thing I've ever done on YouTube. The second question is, what is your most embarrassing and most funniest moment on YouTube? Who or what inspired you to make YouTube videos? Well, I said this in the very beginning, I believe, of this vlog, and it was not really anybody that inspired me. It is I wanted to do it to kind of prove to myself that I just could do it, to get over all the things that have been going on in my life over the years. And I think, as I said, I've safely been able to overcome all that. So I'm really proud of that, out of everything that I've accomplished. And in terms of being embarrassed or funniest moments, I mean, I don't really get embarrassed on YouTube. I mean, I guess my most embarrassing would be some of the first videos I ever released, because I was so freaking clueless of what to do on YouTube. Like, I didn't realize what you had to do in order to get everything going. And, like, I thought that when you just plugged in a microphone, you would sound okay or whatever. And I knew I had a speech problem, and I knew people sound bad to themselves whenever they hear themselves play back. So when I heard that, I was like, okay, well, maybe people think I sound a lot better than I really do. That was not the case at all, because my microphone was so bad. It was like a $10 headset. Like, it was so cheap. It was like it was gonna fall apart, and it was so bad. And the thing is, I didn't realize that most people on YouTube add, like, effects to it. Like, they compress the sound and everything to sound a lot better. And I never realized all that stuff. I thought you just plug it in and you go. And yeah, I guess unless you have, like, a better microphone, you really need to compress the hell out of that thing. I didn't know what the hell I was doing back then. And it's combined with the fact that I couldn't speak properly, and, like, I paused and hesitated all the time. It was a disaster. Like, go back to my Simpsons Tapped Out video, like, the first one I've ever done. Oh, God. The comments, just everybody just ripped into me. They ripped me a new one. But you know what? That's how you learn, right? That's how you learn. Who do you look up to in terms of YouTubers? So this is going to kind of follow the same pattern as my previous comment a second ago, and how I answered it. Nobody inspired me, but over the years, I've learned to really enjoy certain YouTubers. Like PewDiePie, I've always really, really enjoyed his stuff, even though he's kind of moved on to, like, different style, like kind of skits or something. I think that's been really, really interesting, just how you evolve and change over time. And like Jacksepticeye is really, really good as well. For some reason, he's got this, like, infectious, like, style about him that I can't help, but I just love his stuff an awful lot. You know, other people would be Aaron Say What, a really cool YouTuber as well that I've met over the last year. And you know, go down the list, there's a whole bunch that I can list. I love Good Mythical Morning. I love Rhett and Link, those two people. They make me laugh. You know, I have really silly humor, and I find that their humor just really matches mine really, really well. And I could go down the list, but I mean, those are the kind of the core that I always watch and that I really enjoy. My son also has a speech impairment. He stutters a lot and has a tongue tie, so I can understand where you are coming from. I subbed to your channel when I was starting to play the Simpsons Tapped Out game over a year ago, and since then I enjoyed watching your videos, and especially the voiceovers. Laugh out loud, keep them coming, smiley face. So this comment actually got lost in the spam, and I didn't realize it until now when I was looking at some of the questions and stuff. And even though this isn't a question, I just thought, I've got to put it in, because it was so kind, it was so nice, and thank you so much, Maria Hill. I don't know if you still watch my videos, but if you do, thank you so much. It means a lot that you support me in the way that you do, and thank you. Thank you so much. Hey, Casey, how's it going? My question is, has anyone ever met you in public? No, nobody's ever met me in public before. Nobody's ever recognized me in public before. And it actually got me thinking a little while back, like, what would I do for an autograph if I ever came across that? And I actually have come up with something. I was doodling something a while back, and I'm like, maybe this would be really, really good. I'm not going to show you what the hell it is, because it has to be a surprise, damn it, for whenever anybody ever does meet me in public. But that's another thing on my list I really want to do. I want to get a chance to meet you guys. but I don't know how I would go about doing that, because the chances are, you know, where I live and where I would have to go, it's probably a distance factor and everything involved, and I really want to go to like a PAX convention or something down the road, but first of all, it costs money, and second of all, I don't even know what I would do when I would get there, because I'm such a small YouTube channel, like I don't know anybody else that would even go there anyways. I don't know any of the bigger YouTubers and stuff, so I can't really get my foot in the door and stuff, but I mean, if I could somehow get a chance to meet even a few of you, that would be super, super cool, but you know what? Baby steps. Rome wasn't built in a day, or what my mom always tells me. So we're going to stop it here for the questions for now, but if you guys ever do want to ask questions in the future, hashtag AskKastyLovesGaming on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, all that sort of stuff, and I'll compile all the questions and stuff in the future and come up with another Q&A video down the road. So again, guys, thank you so much for the great support over the 4 years that I've been on YouTube. There's a long way to go. I'm not going to sugarcoat it. I've got a lot of work to do to get to the level that I feel that I am even more, I guess, accepting of where I am on YouTube. And it's going to take a lot of work, but I've worked hard up to this point, and I'm going to continue to work my ass off. Language. Booty. But, pukus off to really get where I want to get to in the future. But, you know, it does obviously start with you guys as well, because I've gotten to this point because of you guys, and I'm going to have to rely on you guys even more moving forward to really get anywhere that I want to go. But, as I've said before, baby steps. So thank you everybody again for watching this video. Thank you for the fantastic support for the last 4 years. It's been an incredible, crazy whirlwind of a ride, and I've got no plans of slowing down. Mwah. I love you all, everybody. Bye-bye.